those Cassiopeia. No. Very strange to see it completely go through picks and bans, given the mid lane talent here. Both Kuro, I definitely agree with that. You know, they often do make it to playoffs, but not go further than that. Their fans are super, super loyal. Jhenair, even if they're at the bottom and not gone for a half screen arrow, they could have gone for something a little bit more assured.
Oh boy, this time, this is pretty assured. Yeah, Umti finding two Sid, locks him down as that corrupting, or the chain of corruption comes through from Teddy. First blood picked up. Nice, gets punished for it immediately. Snowflower really good with that exhaust to try to get the kill. Meanwhile, speaking of that, it's going to be the Ash Arrow coming through, but they can't really follow up. And Kramer, he takes that piercing arrow to the face.
That's the flash from Minions. He dies to Minions.
Oh, boy. That is just devastating for a Freak of Freaks. Snowflower will go down, but what a misplay by Kramer getting taken out. Martin is able to come up with a
more.
Kill. Meanwhile, TP in by Iksu. Wants to go ahead and go forward with this. The Tidal Wave comes through, pops him up, but it's not enough. Now the... That's going to be the Weaver's Wall thrown into the back as Gusan tries to cut off Marin. He's still pretty... giving you a run for your money.
Oh, Spirit.
Pushing in. Spirit's going to get found. They kick him right into the face of Kuzan, and he goes down. Can't even react. Doesn't have a flash available to do so. Sonic Wave won't land, but Teddy's going to flash forward. The seismic shove comes through, and Teddy picks himself up a kill in the bottom lane. 5-1. Jhenair. Nearby. They throw a ward into the pit. They want to contest
Equalizer available.
They go ahead, they pop that Umti, goes low, Spear trying to chase in, flashes forward, and he will go down. Marin comes up with a kill. Iksu threw out the depth charge to try to dissuade it, but it was not enough. Flash away from the Lee Sin and the Nautilus, and an Ocean Drake gets handed over to Afrika. So a night.
Yes. Oh, Kramer, he's dead instantly.
Oh boy.
Instantly killed under the turret. This will maybe be with just an edge of the night for Teddy.
I mean, we weren't... Oh, I'll hold that thought as the Ash Arrow comes out. Teddy throws out the Chain of Corruption on the Spirit, but he's able to cleanse it off. And the Equalizer comes down, gets popped back in with a Shockwave, and he goes down.
Throwing the Hunt used to be such a scary thing, but lasts so long now. Marin could turn around with an Equalizer here.
He gets popped up, has that big
great terrain
through.
For it.
Zyra Ultimate being thrown down by Snowflower. Teddy going low, but the Shockwave won't catch him. Just finds Iksu, who will fall as Kuro just autos him to death. Afrika coming up with the kill. Dragging.
20 minutes time, 5,000 gold behind. Well, it's almost that time now.
Arrow comes through, connects on the Snowflower, gets popped up, and he goes down. The Dissonance, all that was required to kill him in conjunction with that Shockwave.
Definitely feel that death cap. Sitting on 1,400 gold, his Spirit's caught, and there's nothing he can do.
Trying to keep him in the pit and have the Baron chunk him down. Umti jumps in on top of him, and he'll get taken out.
That was
nice
creative.
Wall by Kuzan. Yeah, really creative play to get rid of the jungler, but there's still... could be really risky. Weaver's Wall thrown
they
out.
They just want to try and wall them off and try and take the Baron. They're rushing it here.
They have to do this
the
really quickly.
The duration's really long.
Down to 3K. Can they get in there? The Tidal Wave coming through. Redemption thrown down. Won't come up with the steal, but Kuro is able to get rid of Snowflower right off the bat. Umti does confirm the Baron. Dashes out the safety, and Iksu will follow with his flash. And it looks like Jhenair, they might have just gotten away with
a whale down to 5,000. Don't think Lee Sin's going to get there, though.
Kramer does a lot of damage at the moment. You can see that does get taken out at the end. So double buff on that Elder Dragon.
Well, I guess his essence is spotted. Now he's swept. Oh, Equalizer.
So yeah, thrown down. Teddy goes low. They kick in Spirit. He gets knocked in underneath the tower, but it's not enough. Snowflower, first one to fall yet again. Redemption comes down, healing up Umti. He's got that GM.
Nice hook.
Nice stretch line in on the Spirit. He's going to jump away with a flash. Tries to get himself out. Marin and Spirit definitely going to have to try to hightail it out of here. Marin's cut off, but he's going to screw it. I'm just going to go straight into your face, Kuzan. Flashes over the wall, burns him down. Meanwhile, GA does get popped on the Umti and doesn't have much of anywhere
nice.
To go. Gets taken out by Kramer, who's firing away at Iksu, trying to slow up as best as he can. Should be able to do so. Should be able
Kramer's
to make it a double
hitting.
Kill. Teddy goes down. That's going to be the GA popped. Afrika coming up already with 3 kills, looking for a 4th one, as Iksu will certainly fall here. Let's see what they can transition this into, a triple kill going over to Kramer.
Inhibitor turret go down. Death timers are pretty long. They could try to brute force. It is a Taliyah who has good wave clear. So for now, they're looking to stay. Marin can teleport. Kuzan on the team, not ready for that sort
Equalizer
of base.
Throw down. Here comes Marin from the backside, trying to get on top of Teddy. He's going to get popped up, and he gets taken down. Actually, Tucson coming up with the killing blow, and both carries on the side of Jhenair have been taken.
But it felt like Afrika got too interested on
Umti.
Oh, but
Kuro. Yeah, going in on the Umti. Doesn't have that GA. They stun up Iksu. You can see that Equalizer ticking away at him. That
1800
piercing arrow, but it's not enough. The spike comes through, and Spirit is able to pick up the Baron yet again here. This time going over to Afrika Freaks. giant RVs on both sides and crash them into each other.
Why don't they just start picking champions that peak at level 18 across the board? Because the game will get there eventually.
Marin gets caught by Shady Corruption. He takes a lot of damage. But that's not dissuading the rest of Afrika from getting rid of the inhib. So many of these. I would like to know how many times he's used it and not gotten anything.
Oh.
Marin, though, going to get caught.
Are they far enough out of the base?
It finds
they might be.
Big tidal wave coming through. Snowflower goes down. Teddy desperately trying to kite back away from Spirit. And that's going to be a big shockwave.
Oh.
Connects onto Iksu. Not able to find Teddy as he flashes out to safety. But with Snowflower gone, a lot of the peel for Jhin Air has been eliminated. But a big piercing arrow into the back line takes out Kuro. Is that enough to stop Afrika Freaks in their tracks, though? That is the... I don't even know. Oh, there we go! Finally
not
got
at all.
Spirit makes his way into the back. Teddy sticking around for too long. It's taken out. Marin pushing forward.
Goes low.
Tries to get onto Upti, but he's going to get taken out. The Dragon's Rage
dead.
With the help of Iksu, able to finish him off. But Kramer, firing away. Does take out Snowflower, looking for Upti to boot. Dashes away with a ward hop. And they come up with a slow flash bubble from Tucson. It falls way too short, but they'll be able to get the move speed buff from the Scuttle Crab.
He's running towards that minion wave.
Yet again, barely not connecting.
Stop chasing Umti!
They could have went and killed the inhibitor
they're
again.
They're still gonna chase Umti.
Now Kuro's doing it.
I'm so sad.
There we go.
To madness we go. I think I'm ready for the next stage of Grave Killian.
The descent has begun.
What's the stage after Jhin Air?
Death. I don't know. No one ever got that far.
Well, the minion waves are pushing, so I guess if we
head over that one.
All right, they get the inhibitors. That's something.
All right, yeah, looks like Jhin Air.
Is that a teleport? Oh, it is.
Yeah, there's a TP coming through. Ashiro gets thrown out. Elder Dragon comes through. His spirit picks
nice
that one up.
Teddy.
Stretch line onto Tucson. Kramer
low
gets
low
taken
here.
Over the wall. He gets taken
That's
out.
One.
Upti comes up with a kill.
Kuro's dead.
Going into the back line, trying to take out Teddy. But Kuro goes down on the other side of the fight. Tucson.
Jhin Air, you might do it.
Well, they get four kills. It's just Spirit left alive.
But he's only going one
way. On the hunt, goes, jumps on the Teddy, takes him out completely. It looks like he'll be able to get away with his life on top of it all.
And if I learned anything...
Flashes over, goes for Snowflower, finishes him off. The double kill coming in for Spirit. Can he finish off Kuzon? The GA is there. He needs to hightail it out of here. The Super Creeps are still knocking down the Nexus turrets. Can he do anything?
Can we watch the action,
I don't
want to
see him scratch his nose. Show me the fight. 67,
thanks.
35.
Oh, Dredge maybe this is the time.
On to Kuro. He gets popped.
He's
he
dead.
Gets deleted. Upti comes up with a kill. The rest of Afrika have to run for the hills.
They go Marin.
Big seismic shove onto Marin. He makes it into the zone. He's in time, but it looks like he still might go down, and he does. Upti coming up with a double kill. Teddy, he's still alive on the backside, firing off on his Spirit.
I think Jhin Air might win.
A triple kill for Upti. Can he make it a quadra? Looks like the answer is yes. And with that ace, Jhin Air Green Wings, they're going to go. They're going to knock down the Nexus, and they're going to win game one of this best of three series.
Jhin Air smiling. They always do this, Achilles, but they always lose. They're actually going to win this game.
What the hell just happened, Jhin Air? They played to their strengths. They took it beyond an hour. We won't break the record yet, but there's still another game, maybe even two more for that to happen, Papa Smithy.
Jhin Air needs to continue down this trend, straight to madness, extend every game. Why play early games when you can just do